DeSantis also signed a bill that prohibits children under the age of 14 from opening social media accounts.
If the teenager is 14 or 15, they're going to need their parents' permission to open that social media account. The law will also require companies to delete accounts for any kid who is under 14. Tonight, NBC2 Chief Political Reporter Dave Elias is discovering what the bill doesn't say, like how it would be enforced.
Childhood isn't as simple as a playground to occupy a child's time like it once was. Today, the world can be a child's playground, all on a little screen just like this, where teens can get lost for hours. But who should patrol it? And the bigger question is, can they?
Young minds at ease, free from the screen that can sometimes even consume their parents' time.
And ultimately, you know, trying to help parents navigate this very difficult terrain that we have now with raising kids.
That's why Governor DeSantis supports banning social media for kids 14 and under.
Why? Because there's a lot of, you know, sexual stuff that's out there, dangerous stuff that's out there.
The ban requires social media companies like TikTok, Snapchat, or Facebook to delete current accounts of those under 14. Companies that don't delete could be sued and the child awarded $10,000 in damages. And companies could be fined up to $50,000 in violations. What the law doesn't say, though, is how it would be enforced.
So companies will need to figure out who is under 14 and for those with parental consent, who in fact their true guardian is. And that requires vast amounts of data collection.
Amy Boss is with NetChoice, a company that has challenged similar bans in Ohio and Arkansas.
But we're talking about speech here.
At what age should you be given the right of free speech?
We really want to leave this decision in the hands of parents and not the federal government.
Parents like Julie Scalfo, who founded Mothers Against Media Addiction, argues it's the government's right to decide for many parents.
But we don't leave it up to children or individual parents to decide at what age children should start drinking or at what age it's safe for children to view pornography or gamble.
Back at the park, Ashley Ahmed prefers her kids spend more time here and less time on the screen.
You never know who's out there, who's watching, who's listening. And so I want them to know life happens outside of a phone.
The new law set to take effect January 2025, unless the courts rule otherwise. Dave Elias, NBC2.